Hello, I'm Mr. Armour, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. We render an exposition of Ephesians 6:13-24. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God. The armor of God is gospel truth. So if you have the gospel truth, then you can fight the hypocrites. And if you are of the darkness, then you won't fight the hypocrites, but they will kill you with their hypocrisy, and afterward they will eat you. So if you want to be living, have the gospel armor of the living God, the gospel truth, that ye may be able to withstand the hypocrites and blasphemers in the evil day, when people were burned to stake by the Antichrist, and having done all to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with gospel truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. The breastplate should be of righteousness, meaning that you should not do favor to anyone. So when you are doing justice, or you are dealing with anyone, be impartial like a little children. I can tell you, you know, you won't find such a person in this world so easily. So such are the people who are the customers of my gospel, who are the customers of the gospel of God, which I preach. So my preaching is not appreciated by many, because most of them, they are partial hypocrites. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, that you should, when you walk, you should have preach the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith in Christ Jesus, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. So unless you have faith yourself in God, you can't fight the hypocrites. So you have to take the shield of faith in Christ Jesus, and take the helmet of salvation and the double-edged sword of the Holy Spirit, our gospel truth, which is the word of God. So gospel truth is the double-edged sword that clears any misunderstanding in your heart and also in the other people, in other brethren. Pondering and not praying always with all humbleness, and not prayer and supplication in the spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. Saints don't need any praises. They don't need any prayer or supplications. Their praises lie with God and not with the people. We honor saints for the gospel they preach. And for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel. So nobody needs the protection of men. In God, when we preach gospel, God is our protector, not any man. So we should not seek any praises of men or protection of men. Our praises and protection lie with our Father God, for which I am an ambassador in bonds to Christ Jesus, who set him free. Remember that Christ Jesus set Saul free of the bond of the rabbis. So in his honor, he is preaching all that gospel to people and working hard to earn forgiveness for the persecution he had done in under blindness. So we are the spokesmen of God. So in Christ Jesus, all the saints and apostles, they were spokesmen with capital S. We, being having spirit with small s, we are spokesmen with small s. We can make mistakes, but apostles can't, because they have the very spirit of God. That therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak, but that ye also may know my affairs and how I do. Tychicus, a beloved brother and faithful minister in our Father God and not the Lord of the Antichrist, shall make known to you all things. So he sent one of his brother apostle to them, so that everything he cleared their doubts. Whom I have sent unto you for the same purpose, that ye might know our affairs, and that he might comfort your hearts. So that he was sent, you know, so he can tell you how we are doing, how we are faring, and also give you comfort your hearts. Peace be to the brethren, and love with faith from God the Father and our elder anointed brother Christ Jesus, and not the Lord of the Lord Jesus of the Antichrist. Grace be with all them that have covenant with our Father God in honor of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, and not our Lord Jesus Christ, in love and in sincerity. Amen. So here, you know, the Saint Paul is giving them sending them a message. In fact, you know, the apostles in their epistles try to make the people morally sound, and that involves the, remember how the Samaritan woman at the well, she had five husbands. In spiritual term, a husband is one who dominates you. So those five husbands were the one who work against spirituality. They are, first one was immorality, or what we call kaam in our Punjabi. Kaam mean the sex undue. That involves immorality. So first is immorality involving physical body, and the second one is the of the spiritual people who are twice born and doubting. They go for money or for God. To avoid them from going for money, greed is the one which dominates them. So the second husband, the second husband are the once born people who are not of spirit, and they are once born like natural men. So anger dominates them, as it dominated Peter when he asked Jesus and start rebuking him, when Jesus told him that he is going to Jerusalem to die. So that's the second husband. Third husband is the one of the twice born people who are of doubting type, and they want to go for money. So you have to control yourself, control your mind, not to cheat anybody. So when you have controlled it, then the third husband, greed, you have overpowered. The fourth husband is that when you are become an old wise person, and then your worldly temptation, you have big house, children you have, property you have, money, everything, that deter you to go for wilderness, to preach gospel, and to make 100%. You remember the type of soils Jesus mentioned? Some were the footpath, once born people, rocky soil, twice born with the doubting heart, and the third one, the wise people, but the worldly things choke their fruit, and the last one, the soil free of the weeds, that is the wilderness. So then you, if you go for wilderness, and then you overpower everything.